My name is Emily Donovan. I live in Brunswick County, North Carolina, where we have some of the highest levels of PFAS detected in our tap water based on a recent nationwide study done by the Environmental Working Group. PFAS are a class of synthetic chemicals linked to serious health effects like thyroid disease, immune system disorders, high cholesterol, obesity, infertility, and several cancers. In fact, I live in one of the largest thyroid cancer clusters in the state of North Carolina. We call PFAS forever chemicals because they don't degrade, and there's no proven safe disposal method for these toxins after their intended use. Yet the chemical industry thought it was a brilliant idea to put these forever chemicals in thousands of consumer products. PFAS are so toxic, we talk about them at trace amounts. They build up in our bodies, we can't flush them out easily, and just about every American has some level of PFAS in their blood, like 99% of us. And sadly, we are learning firefighters are getting hit the hardest with occupational exposures to PFAS. 3 years ago, I learned I've been giving my children toxic levels of PFAS since their birth. I know way too many people in my community who are my age battling cancer. My own husband survived a brain tumor shortly after we moved to this area. He nearly lost his eyesight, and I worry constantly for his health. Nancy Beck was in charge of the EPA's Office of Chemical Safety 3 years ago when North Carolina needed her the most, and she did nothing. She ignored multiple bipartisan requests from our governor and our Senator Richard Burr. The PFAS contamination crisis that I live in impacts over 250,000 North Carolina residents, and she ignored pleas from our highest levels of elected leadership. If she refuses to listen to our well-respected elected officials, how can we trust she'll listen to the public and independent scientists, all of which would be part of her new job leading the Consumer Product Safety Commission? She refused to close a loophole in a critical EPA consent order regarding DuPont and Chemours, the chemical companies responsible for my community's suffering. She ignored requests from North Carolina leadership to quickly finalize EPA health assessments for Gen X, one of the newer PFAS found in our drinking water. She refused to prioritize Gen X and other PFAS for risk evaluations under TSCA. She failed to protect all of us from toxic PFAS chemicals coming to the marketplace. She actively worked against Congress to weaken how the EPA responds to the most recent bipartisan PFAS legislation. And she even blocked the release of a critical CDC report detailing the EPA's existing PFAS health advisories were too weak to actually protect the public. These are the advisories water utilities use all across the nation to tell communities like mine that this glass of water is either safe to drink or not. I just don't understand why we would allow someone who comes to work and does nothing and get nominated for a promotion. Nancy Beck refuses to do her job, and I can't do my job as a wife and a mother. I can't protect my family from further exposures to PFAS chemicals. I can't prevent avoidable harms. My area can't afford one more drop of PFAS chemicals in our air, our soil, our water, our food supply, or the products we purchase. I still have no idea why my friend Sarah's cancer came back so quickly, and neither does her doctor who cried when he told her the news. I have no idea how long my friend Tom has to live, and I have no idea why my friends are all developing thyroid disease, and neither do the doctors in our area, but we all know something's wrong. And I have no idea if my children would develop any of the health effects we know are associated with PFAS. And I wonder about the health effects we still don't know about because Nancy Beck refused to do her job. This is not just irresponsible, it's deadly. There are lives on the line. And we deserve so much better. And I urge every senator to oppose Nancy Beck's nomination.